Tired of small fish tearing up your crawlers and leaving you with downtime on the water?
Uncle Josh's pork crawlers get bit just as good as live bait, but last longer, which leads to more fish in the boat.
It's a nice fish. This is that one that we were running a little bit higher, Matt. This one's probably only running down about 14 foot, so.
That's interesting.
Once this board comes in, can you take that off for me? Take him.
That's a big fish.
Nice fish.
Ho ho.
Nice fish.
Really nice fish.
Look at that thing, it has a face full of pork.
Wow. Hey, today on Midwest Outdoors, we're on the Bay of Green Bay. I'm Matt Bichonich with Uncle Josh, and I got Tom Kimos, our pro staffer. And this is our first pass, folks, with the new Uncle Josh pork nightcrawler.
This is such a cool situation right now, because one of the things that I really wanted to show everybody today is how versatile this pork product is. This has been our inside bait. It's been running up real shallow, and this whole pass, it's been down on the bottom, scratching bottom a little bit. The beauty of this is if that we had a real crawler on here, we wouldn't have had any bait on, because the gobies would have just ate it.
That's a great point.
The cool thing about this is you can put it out there and forget about it until that board peels back. These fish on these deep rocks up here are just beautiful, aren't they?
Awesome.
Let's get this one back and get some more.
Let's do it.
There he goes. Nice start.
Awesome. Oh, this one's got some weight, Tommy.
Hey, Matt, just walk up towards the front a little bit. Keep reeling nice and steady.
It's at 20.
All right,
15.
Cool. We got a snap weight on that one, so I'm gonna get that snap off, and then there's 20 feet behind it. So.
Okay. Felt the big head shake.
Oh yeah.
Head shaker.
See him, he's another nice fish. There we go.
Woo!
Another nice chunky fish.
Big chunk.
Oh. Look at the color.
Beautiful.
That one's a little bit skinnier, but it's still a real stocky fish, you know? Just another real nice spinner fish. And the old meat did the trick again, huh?
That was awesome.
Whoa, that one was ready to go. Hey, that water is getting a little cold too, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's dropping down to the low 60s here, but they're still eating spinners.
You know what's happening is we're kind of getting into that mid to late fall period here. It's getting on almost towards October, and our water temperatures have dropped into the low 60s, which is just a little bit below what I would prefer for spinner fishing. And what happens is it kind of slows those fish down, and it turns them a little nocturnal. But you can still catch these fish during the day with spinners. You just need to slow down and really kind of grind through them. So many of these lakes have zebra mussels in them now. And what it's done is it's cleaned the water up so much that you really have to have more of a finesse technique to get these fish to bite now, especially during the day. In this clear water, it's important to have a bait that absolutely duplicates that crawler action, that tail action that I'm always talking about. And the thing about pork, this is actually made of pork fat, and the beauty of it is that pork fat is buoyant, as you know so well.
Mm-hmm.
And what that does is it creates an extremely lifelike and finesse presentation, just like a live crawler. The fact that it floats, I mean, it just undulates in the water, just like the real crawler, and you get that nice, the tail flicking action that looks just like a bait fish or a wounded bait fish skipping through the water. Heavy fish, huh?
Oh yeah, he's heavy, Tommy, he's heavy.
Oh yeah, he's staying straight down.
Oh, this feels good. Feels really, oh baby.
Oh yeah, I see him down there, he's a
look at that head shaking.
Nice fish.
That gin clear water, he sees that boat and he's a shaking.
There we go.
Yeah. Oh, was that a fight? That was awesome.
Hey, nice fish, Matt.
Thanks.
Another dark rock fish.
Oh,
look at how beat up they get from the zebra mussels. You know, they're down there rooting around eating gobies and stuff.
Boom, hammering them.
That's how you want them hooked right there. He's just pegged right there in the roof of the mouth.
Still got our worm?
Yep, we're
ready
good to
for
go.
Another pass.
Get that pork crawler reset and go get after it again, huh?
Awesome.
This is a big one, Matt. See how that board's rolled over like that?
Yep.
That's good stuff there, buddy.
Nice.
Boy, I want to see this one.
Oh yeah, feels like a real nice one. Feels like the kind you roll up here for. Look at the size of that thing. Here he comes, Matt. See if you can reach out for him. Let's scoop, scoop, scoop. We got another one going here, boys.
Doubling up on the pork.
Oh, this is another big one too. Oh man, this is a tank. Look at that, it's taking that board under. That's what you want to see right there, man.
Dude, to get double up like this.
Well, and we just lost that other one too. So it's so important when you're searching to make sure that you pay attention. You know, when you finally do start zeroing in on the fish, it's so important to know exactly how much line you had out so you can duplicate that.
Oh, is that a big fish?
Oh, yeah! That's what we're talking
That's
about.
That's what it's all about. I haven't had a chance to put this one in the water, Tommy, and then you just pulled in an absolute giant.
Yeah, look at that sled.
Boy. And that's unbelievable. Going back to what we said earlier, just knowing that that worm's on that harness, and here's the results right here, folks.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, we were just scratching. We came up over that rise there, and, you know, normally I'd have said, we got to reel these things in because the goby's probably cleaned us off. But with those poor crawlers, I know that we're still fishing, you know. So it's an awesome point of confidence to have.
Hey. I know I want to keep holding these up, but I want to make another pass.
Yeah, you bet. Reel. There you go. Nice fish.
Oh, yeah. This has got some nice shoulders, easy, Tommy. Dude.
Yeah, it's got that board straight down, doesn't it? Nice and easy. He's going to make a power dive.
Just ripping that drag, Tom. Ripping that drag.
Got him! Woo! Awesome. Boy, is that a chunky fish.
Man, he battled.
Oh, man, I thought that was a 10-pounder. Tell you what, it sure fought like one, and you know what? Someday it will be a 10-pounder, but not today.
He crushed that pork worm. And folks, to check out all of Uncle Josh's full line of pork baits, go to UncleJosh.com. I'm Matt Bachanich. This is Tommy Kimos. And Midwest Outdoors will be right back.